Today I will be showing you the privacy settings that I use in Internet Explorer and Firefox. There will be a timestamp in the video description for each browser so you can click ahead to your preferred browser. For Firefox, you just go up to the menu button in the top right hand corner and you click it, and then you click Options. And then you go down to Privacy. In Privacy, you put a check mark in Tell Sites That I Do Not Want to Be Tracked. And then here under History, you go to Use Custom Settings for History. Now you want to put a check mark in Remember My Browsing and Download History, Remember Search and Forum History, Accept Cookies from Sites, and where it says Always Accept Third-Party Cookies, you put From Visited, so it will only give you cookies from web pages that you visit. And where it says Keep Until, you want to select I Close Firefox. That way when you close Firefox, your cookies will be deleted. Then you want to put a check mark in Clear History when Firefox closes, and then you click Settings. And here you want to put a check mark in every single box. You can leave site preferences unchecked if you feel like it, because that preserves the site preferences. So for example, if you go to a site and you've chosen a certain color or font to be displayed, for example on a forum board or another web page, then it will remember. And that's not as big of a deal as the rest of the settings are. And then you just click OK. The next thing you want to do is go to Security and uncheck Remember Passwords for Sites. That way, if you ever let somebody else use your computer to check something, then they won't be able to access a page that you have accessed, and it's just a little bit more secure that way. And the last place you want to go to is Advanced, and here where it says Offline Web Content and User Data, it will actually tell you if the site is going to store any data, but you can also clear it by clicking Clear Now. Other than that, that's pretty much all the settings that I use for privacy in Firefox. For Internet Explorer, it's a little bit more difficult and it takes a little bit longer, but what you want to do is go up to this cog, that is the Tools. You can also just press Alt and X, and then you want to go down to Safety. And then you want to go down to Turn On Tracking Protection. And this will prevent you from being tracked when you visit certain websites. So you click that. And you can get a tracking protection list online. I won't do that now, but it's pretty simple. I use Easy List Tracking Protection. And you want to go back up to that cog and then Safety. And then turn on Do Not Track Requests. And you can click Turn On, and you also have to close the browser and open it again in order for it to work. The next thing you want to do is go back up to that cog and then click Internet Options. And then under Internet Options, you want to go to Browsing History, put a check mark in Delete Browsing History on Exit. And then when you click Delete, you'll notice that it doesn't have Download History, Forum Data, Passwords, and Tracking Protection, ActiveX Filtering, and Do Not Track checked. So you want to check all of those, and then click Delete. And you don't have to do that all of the time, just maybe when you're planning to let somebody else use the computer or planning to be away from the computer and somebody else may be using it. And under Settings here, you want to go to History and then set it to 1 day. It's by default, it's set to 20. And if you set it to 1 day, it will only keep history for 1 day. And that's as safe as you can get. And then you click OK. And then you click Apply. The next thing you want to do is go to Privacy and then go to Advanced, and here it says First Party Cookies and Third Party Cookies. Now, unlike Firefox, you can't choose from Visited Only. You either have to accept, block, or prompt. Now, the safest option for third party cookies would be to choose Prompt, and then click OK. You can also just leave the third-party cookies as accept. Other than that, that's pretty much all you have to do for Internet Explorer. Now, you will have to restart your computer because of the Do Not Track requests, and it's not just restarting your browser, but you also have to restart your computer, and then you will be all set and ready to go with Internet Explorer. Of course, these settings can be changed according to personal preference. These are just my settings. Subscribe or visit my YouTube channel.